हेलो एवरीवन।
हेलो, कैन यू गाइस हियर मी? हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एंड होप यू ऑल हैड अ वेरी नाइस वीकेंड। ओके, सो लेट्स गिव अस कपल वन मोर मिनट। Okay, so looks like it's 5 o'clock. So good evening, everyone, and I hope you all had a nice weekend. So I'll start. So today's theme. Thank you for my kids drawing to give me opportunity to showcase another nice painting. So I'll start with some of the pre setup things. So this is my board where I have kept my my item paint sheet. So this is the board. What I am doing it here right now, I have this sheet which is 250 GSM actually. So you can get it by from Amazon. It's pretty cheap. It's not costly, so you'll get it in like 200 rupees, 50 sheets or 100 sheets depending upon this thing. Best to buy the minimum 200 GSM, but 160 GSM also will be fine. Okay, so I put that same sheet over here and I use this tape. So this is tape, surgical tape. I think if you go and buy for it, and you can actually put the edges so that your sheet will be intact. You don't have to fear about getting loose and give the this. I think this pad is also a plastic pad, or you can use any cardboard also. It's fine. So once this is placed, this is A4 by the way. This is A4 sheet. There are different variations are there. You can get the A3 also. A3 will be a little bit bigger. Okay. So I'm going to use a couple of brush here. So I'll explain what and all brushes I'm going to use. So this is flat brush. It's good for doing that smudging and then adding spreading the color across. And this is I'm going to use it at the put that pressure and apply that things. So it's sprinkling some of the things I'm going to use this thing. And this is thin brushes. So these will be used these brushes will be used for normal detailing work. So that's what I'm going to use. Then I'll show you that this is normal cloth. So I'll be using this normal cloth. So this is just to make sure that your brush should not get too much wet. So you can just whenever it's get too wet, you can just put it here and it will become dry it out and then use it. That way you will not avoid too much water splashes on the screen. Okay, so now next thing is I'm going to use little bit cotton as well. So this cotton will help us to make sure that that color get balanced out. So when you merge or mix with the color like blue and orange, you can actually make sure that there is no differences at all. So the smudging part will be used for that. So yeah, I think, and definitely you need a clean water, so where you can actually clean and wipe your brushes. Okay, I have a color set. This is very standard color acrylic set. So this is black. It's a black color. Then this is white. So I'll explain it. This is black. This is titanium white. This is your lemon yellow. And I have this is crimson lake. It's kind of a red only, but it's a different this thing. This is scarlet color. This is very standard acrylic paint, and this is from Camlin, so it's not very costly. You get it and at least it will can give you at least close to 50 to 60 painting you can make it out of it. And the only color you have to buy, I think most of the color is fine. The one color you have to keep buying is the white. This white is the very important color in the whole acrylic set. It's actually going to balance out your whole color. So to keep that thing, I think you can keep buying. Once you buy this thing and you keep buying white colors. So that's about the color. I hope so all the things are set. So we'll start with I think the theme today is the sunrise on the river bank. So I'll start with that. If any one of you have any questions or anything, please feel free to jump in, message it in comments. I can keep on seeing that thing. Okay. Yes, you can use the poster color. The difference between the acrylic and the poster color is basically pastel color, I guess. I think that's what you are mentioning over there. Acrylic is something you can actually put it on top of also. You don't have to worry about the smudging. I think if pastel colors work that way, then you can get, sometimes you can get the translucent as well. Any other question? You don't need canvas cloth. This is normal paper. I think Lavina, you asked for that. So this is normal paper. This is 250 GSM paper. You can use 200 GSM paper also. It will work fine. You don't need canvas cloth for acrylic painting at all. It's not, you don't need a big canvas paper, a canvas sheet and all. And when you buy the cloth, you need to buy a gesso also. So I'm not going to use gesso here. Gesso is another technique where we first put the one white gesso. Too much work over there. We'll use the normal color, how you can actually use the acrylic paints and how you can create your own drawing. So I'm going to use without gesso here and without the canvas cloth. It's on the paper. It's 250 GSM. Okay, I'll see if any other questions. Okay, so as I said, I'm going to start with nature painting. So let's get it started. Okay, so one more thing. This is my palette board. So in this one, I'm going to add my colors. And I'm going to mix the color and everything. And one more thing is to keep in mind, in the acrylic paints, it's very important, they get very dry very easily. So you need to make sure that use as much, how much ever you require. Should not take out more acrylic paint, or else you will be getting, it will get dry and then you cannot reuse it. So it's best to use the acrylic paint how much ever you want. Don't over put it on the palette and then it will get dry out. And it will be no use. And you can see the spots over here. These are the acrylic paints which get dried out. And so you need to make sure that as soon as you finish with your painting, you should wash it up and things like that. Otherwise, it will remain going to stain. So let's get started. So the fundamental things is, so I have this brush. So the brush, one, to take care of your brush, make sure that once you use it, you should clean your brush. Should not let it don't dry with the paints. Otherwise, your brush will get spoiled. If you take care of your brush, it will going to be a lifelong. So you don't have to worry about buying every time the brush. So make sure that once you use it, dry, clean it and dry it out and then store it. It will always be going to be soft. You don't have to worry about that. So I'll just make it a little bit wet with water, this one, so that it get at least contain the moisture. So acrylic will not get dry if you it is maintain the proper moisture into that. So just to make sure that you are working in not in very too much fan area where too much fan is there, otherwise your paint will get dry. Okay, so I'll take little bit yellow on my palette and just okay, so let's start with that. So I'm just taking it up. So this is how it's going to be boundary is going to be created on the board. So I'll start with first putting the yellow. Okay, so this is morning sunrise. So as everyone seen that morning sunrise will have little bit yellowish and orange, little bit red, and so many things, a dark blue sky. Okay, I'll take little bit orange and you don't have to worry about if anything is like going to, so you can just use your orange, use your imagination how much ever it is possible. You don't have to worry about what you're going, it's going to be nice and easy. Just let your brush do the talking, all the things. Let the brush do the things. So you can see that little bit yellow is getting mixed with yellow. Okay, so that's fine. That's totally okay. Okay. Now I'll just keep put little bit more orange. Very simple, you just let it be this way, and I just take this yellow little bit and okay, so now I'll take little bit Crimson Lake, that's a red, it's a little bit translucent, but that's totally fine. This will, I'll mix little bit white with this one, so since it's too dark and we need that little bit white glow into that one, so I'll take that one. And so I just mix it and I'll just pull that these two color together. And I'll mix it here so that I can get the correct mixture over here. Ooh, this is nice. So I'll just see that orange is getting mixed. Don't worry about that thing. That's how we want it. So we want that orange to get mixed with that little bit this. It's okay. Let it get mixed. It will get mixed. So the idea of this thing is you can just keep on putting that that same flow. Don't worry about, see I'm not going from you know down actually, because I know my color has little bit red into this one, so if I go there then it color will get mixed. so I'm just keeping it little bit flow upward so it get lighter and lighter above. And I'll just take a little bit red. Okay. I'm just doing it normal speed. It's okay. If anyone of you are getting miss, I'll repeat. Don't worry. I'll just be doing that little bit shade. Okay, I'll take little bit orange here so that it get mixed with little bit. See, this is how we can mix the color. The boundary will be saturated and I'm just taking a little bit orange and red. Okay, hope I'll continue this one, little bit yellow here. Okay. Okay, looks like we got our nice this thing. Okay, now we'll take little bit blue. And little bit white. Okay, so I took this color. Now I'll pull both color at the same time, white and blue, and I'll just use this one. And I'll just start with this. If it gets too darker, don't worry. You can use that white to bring that color up. So you can can you guys see me? Can you guys hear me? Okay, it looks like I had some internet issues, but yeah. Okay. Yeah, don't worry. I'll be repeating the same step. So, this one just you can just fill it with little bit. If at any point of time you feel like your brush is getting too dry, just dip it, and what you can do is put in a water and just put it on the cloth. Excess water will get dried out and then you can get back to the business. Here, make that little bit white and this thing. Just normal crisscross pattern. You don't have to Same thing, we'll do that this side as well. Okay, let it flow. Don't worry about this thing. You can, your color get mixed, that's what we want. That is sky, how you can see that you can't differentiate between the colors, so that's how it is going to be. So you can just keep mixing your color and let it flow. Don't worry, we are going to fill the cloud as well. So all these boundaries and everything, you are going to see it. Okay, so looks like our sky is almost ready. Now, what we are going to do is, we are going to create a illusion of water. Alright, so to do that thing, we'll create our first river. So river is, yes, of course, there's a blue, and so I'm going to use the same blue, and I have white here, so I'm just going to mix it. So I'll get nice light blue color. Okay. Okay, so I'll use little bit space here. I am going to show you why. But for now, I'm going to use little bit of boundary over here, and I'm going to use, this is my river. So just use this river. Okay. It's very simple. River creating is very nice. You can just let the brush do the things. You just need to put the color and the whichever color you want to have a river. Like if you some river has a green color also. If you go to in Varanasi and all, you can see a little bit muddy color. Ganga has a muddy color. I think Kaveri has a little bit greenish green color. So you can see whichever color you want for your river, you can create it. I'm using blue. I like blue color. So, but you can use any color. It's totally up to you. You can have a red color river also. Red color river comes usually flow because of it comes from the red soil. So if you have a red soil nearby, you will have a color, river color will be a little bit red. Okay, if your river is coming from too much polluted area, then definitely it will be having a black color. So choice is yours. So but we are creating a nature painting, so definitely we don't want can you guys hear me? Is it clear? Voice is clear now? Okay, so I again took that little bit color more here, and I'm going to mix it with white. Nowadays natures are getting too much troll. They are taking it because of human activities. So we have to take some responsibility. We need to make sure that we take some action. So I definitely want you guys to use less merchandise which going to harm nature. Especially the kids can take this action. They should not take too much plastic. So too much uses of plastic should not be used. Mother Nature doesn't like that thing. We get a lot of oxygen, a lot of things from the Mother Nature. So in return, they are just looking for to have a clean environment. The clean environment is the healthy environment sign. I'm encouraging you all of you to at least do the some plantation work, some flower pots in your house. That will give you the nice thought process when you, you know, do the paintings. So this painting will definitely bring that. That's how you want to live in the world. So this painting is nothing but the world you want for yourself. So that's what the painting means. What you're looking for it from the painting is basically the world around you. So I'm looking today, world is should be clean, everyone is healthy. That's what we are hoping for it. Okay, looks like we have a river texture is almost coming up now. Let's do the reflection. So we'll start with the reflection now. Okay, so I'll take little bit yellow. So just put the reflection like this. So it's water, so your reflection can be a big glass. Let's take little bit orange. Then I'll take little bit red, pink. Let it get mixed. It's okay. Okay. Now things are getting mixed up. So reflection is coming up. At any some point you feel that okay, this is not working fine, don't worry, you can just roll back to the previous one. So like I just want that this yellow to become on top of that everything. So okay, now I'll take a little bit a dry brush. So I'll just take that dry brush so that my color get mixed up. Looks like some white is needed here. So it's okay, we'll fill it with. Now we have filled it. Okay, now what we are going to do is, now we are going to create our, we'll take a little bit black and we are going to create a little bit shadow effect. So I'll take little bit this smaller brush so that I can generate a shadow and this thing. So I'll take this one, mix proper black, and I'll create a bushes like this. And So it's like beyond the horizon, little bit. You can make it like this. Okay, so our bushes are getting ready. You can try whichever way you want, because this is your painting. You are creating it your own way of doing things. This is I am seeing it, but you might be creating a much better than this. So my small trees are getting created. This is very far, so you can't see that. Okay, what exactly is like that? So instead of creating the illusion of trees, so the same thing goes on to the this thing. So this will be our. So I'll just fill it with this. So it's fine. Decide any color, black. You can probably take some blue color also, some dark brown. You can mix it with some red. That will give you another a nice gesture on this thing. That's totally up to you. That's no rule book. The best thing is about the painting is there is no rule book. So you can decide whatever the color, whatever the choice you want to make over here. Okay, so now this is water, so I'm just going to create a little bit illusion of a shadow. Shadow is just nothing but whatever you see up, you just need to draw it. Creating a shadow is very easy. You can use the same brush, just use the lighter shade of it. Okay, don't worry. I think some of you, I couldn't do it. Okay. It's okay. I think this session is also getting recorded, so perhaps I think later the video will be available for this thing. But take your time. This is not a competition or anything. You have to participate and you have to win. You can actually take your time, decide, take how much of a time. Go one by one step. Don't have to rush it. There is no rushing into the painting. It's okay. Once you get practice, once you get hold on to it, you can actually do much more better painting than me. So don't worry if you are not able to do catch up, it's okay. Take your time. This is your painting, not someone else. Okay, so we have our. Let's go to the part where we create some ground. So ground is usually grass, and so first we'll make the base for the ground. So ground base is very simple. Take a black, sorry, brown color, and we'll take some dark green. I'm using sap green. Enough of it, and so this is the brown and green. So I'm just going to take this one and just I'm just going to make it like full ground. It's okay. So you can, your base is your ground. Mother Earth is getting created now. It's very simple, just dark brown and green. I hope. Take your time, don't rush it. It's okay. One step at a time. Everyone has a different way of doing things. Someone is left-hander, someone is right-hander. You can't force everyone to do the same way. You can try your own way. Take your time. You can use ground with any color. You can use, there are a different colors. You can start with yellow, red. So I'm in Bangalore, so here the soil color is little bit red, dark red, brown. So it's fine if you use that color also. You don't have to choose the brown and green. It's totally up to you. Okay. There's no rush to it. What color you choose. This is your world. So you are creating a fantasy of your own. This your imagination. You don't have to worry about what color I'm using it. What color you want in your painting. That's important. So my ground is getting created. It's simple, just let it the brush do the talking. I'm using this thing. So in the river side area, you can see that there are so much good this fertile lands are there. It's the reason is rivers brings lot of good source of biological things. They bring it to their banks, and so the grasses will be much more greener on the banks. So that's how the grass is on the greener on the every riverside. And if you see, all the civilization started from the river. So our Indian civilization is also started from the riverside. So this is the beginning of the civilization. Okay, so our base is ready. Now we'll do some trees. Now trees are the basic this thing. So I clean my brush. Now I'll take that little bit. I'll take the thin brush. Make sure to keep cleaning your brush, otherwise your brush will get spoiled very easily. Okay, that's the best thing to do if you really love your brushes. Okay, now I am going to take that complete black, this thing. I'll fill it with complete black. So I have now solid black this thing, and I'll create a tree structure. So I'll take pull that one branch like this. Trees are never a straight line, so don't worry about if your trees are falling, coming as a some trees are crooked, so it's fine. Okay, I'll take a little bit more black color. Okay, so I'll take a little bit water, make it a little bit hydrated, this thing, and yeah, the idea of the painting is anyone can start the painting. It's not a thing like, okay, I don't know how to do this thing, so it's not about that. You can, if you are a novice also, it's fine. So I have so many trees here, so I'll just take and I'll just put it. Okay, so it looks like this side two trees, so I can make one more tree here, so it looks like balance on the both the side. So I'll start with small this thing, and then okay, so let's do that one more. Okay, so now we have a tree. Now there is a one more thing we are going to do. We are going to create our clouds. So we have these lines, right? Before we create a tree structure, we'll create a little bit cloud. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take little bit cotton this way. It's really work out very well. So I'll use this as a you can hide your all the edges into this thing so that it will feel like submerged. It really works. Cotton is really good if you are creating a cloud. Just like how the cloud look like a fluffy cotton, you can use the cotton to create your cloud. And you have now your, okay, looks like I took the black accidentally. Don't worry, we'll fix it up using white. It's no worry, see, some clouds are little bit light color, like a gray color. So this is how it's going to be. So I'll just put little bit. So some color get mixed like a red, so it can give you the nice texture as well. don't have to worry about. We'll take that little bit of yellow. So that our rays will look like okay, now your cloud and your tree looks like it's almost done. I'm just going to use the little bit black. It's okay, Lavina. I think I am pretty sure that your painting will be beautiful in your this thing. Just like how every parents love their kid. Every parents like their boy as a king and the girl as a queen. So I'm definitely princess and prince, basically. Sorry, king and queen. So just like that, it's your painting. You have to love it, because that's how other you are going to create more and more masterpiece. You don't have to worry about what other things about your painting. You are expressing your ideas, not. So painting is giving you a path how you can actually create your journey, right? You don't have to worry about what other things about your painting, right? So I'll take little bit red here. I'll mix it this. So it's very simple. You don't have to, you can actually make a whole painting from the cotton itself. You don't have to actually use the brush at all. I think probably in future session I can show you guys. You can just use the whole cotton, just cotton only, and you can make. And some people even use the finger to make the painting. That's really amazing how they actually have the full control. So it's all about how you have a control. So there are so many ways you can actually do that thing. Okay, so looks like I have my everything is ready. Just little bit darken this tree. Okay. Okay, so now I'm going to take my thin brush and I'm going to make a branches out of it. So branches are like little bit. Take the branches, so tree branches, any way, whichever way you want, you can just create it. You don't have to be very precise about it. It's really easy. You can make a big branch, or you can make a smaller branch. It's very straightforward. Just keep letting your brush do the job. it's okay, Gunjan. I'm telling you this, your painting will be much more better if you just look closely. Everyone's painting is beautiful in their own aspects. You should look for that. This is your first attempt. Not everyone can be that much courageous to start the painting. So I'm really appreciating that all of you, those who are starting the painting. Painting is one of a meditation technique also. If you are doing a painting, it actually calms your nerves. You can make yourself forget about the things of your past. So painting is really, really is very expressive. So you can think about whatever way you want, color, everything, composition. So looks like I have a basic branch set. Now let's create some tree, nice tree structure. So, okay, I'll take a green. Green. And I have this brush with me. So I'm going to take this brush and I'll hold it like this. This is very thick brush, so I'll just hold it like this. And you can just use brush like this. See, you don't have to be very precise over here. Okay, so let's create a brush and use this. So your tree is getting ready. See, you don't have to be worried about which. Just hide your branches, it will automatically come. And you have to tap your brush with the color. That's it. You don't have to worry about. So wherever the branches are there, it's a nice way of understanding the nature. Wherever you have the branches, there will be a tree leaves. So that's what we are doing it here. So we are starting from top and it's completely dub. Looks like our tree branches are done. Okay, so it will be this way. I'll wipe my brush. Okay, now we'll add little bit shining to our. I'll mix yellow with the green, so that will give us a nice shining structure for our You can use any color. I'm using yellow and green. You can use orange and green. You can use any color. Any. There's no hard feeling. Okay. So I'll use little bit. And so that it can give the depth to this thing. The leaves depth is coming up. So now our depth is for the tree. I can use little bit orange, no problem. Orange will give the different meaning. It's fine. I can use little bit red. So some trees has the orange leaves as well. So it's totally fine if you use orange. Let's use little bit red also. It's okay. Let's do the experiment. It's okay. Don't worry about what will happen. It's okay. Let's do the experiment of putting little bit orange, red color. Let it be colorful. Okay, so now we have still little bit in the ground. You can see there is so much depth is missing. So I'll take little bit green and yellow. And we'll do the same magic in the ground also. Because ground also grass, right? So grass require, but I'll use little bit show the reflection of ground here. Just dub 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 tap. You can just keep on tapping on this thing so your grass will look much more depth to it, and use the yellow. So yellow will bring the sunlight color. Okay, this side little bit dark. It's like sunlight is not reaching. It's fine. So we'll make the grass a little bit going upward. So that it feels like, okay, grass is growing up. The little bit bushes. Okay, this side also. Okay, let's create a some sunlight illusion. And sunlight illusion is just work it out. So grass is getting shinier on the light is getting reflected. Okay, let's make some detail work. Detail work is like some of the tree will have nice black and green texture. So let's make the tree structure. Some painter usually some artists they basically use knife and all. So you can use knife if you are good with this thing. So knife is nothing but you can, if in your house you have a cutlery, you can use that as a scraping tool. Okay. Yes, I think that's absolutely right. The idea of this thing is not to worry about how it is look like. It's about how you enjoy doing the painting, guys. That's very important. We are here to encourage you to do as much as possible. Don't try to be perfectionist at the beginning. It's okay. It takes time. Okay. Take your time. Give yourself, let your emotions flow. Whatever emotion you have, if you have happy emotions, you will draw happy paintings. If you are sad, you'll draw the sad pictures. That's how it is. Painting speaks about your thing, instincts, and it will also guide you into the right direction. So don't worry about what painting color and things like that. All paintings are good. Everyone has a painting. I don't know if you guys are watching a news. There is a news that there's a raccoon who is drawing the painting. So it's how he expresses, how he do the things. It's totally up to us. So we can decide what is how we are going to feel about ourselves. So please not worry about this thing. So we'll just fill this. Okay. I'll take little bit white, so water has a little bit froth into it. I'm not talking about the froth what we have in our Bangalore lakes. They are quite polluted, that's why they have a froth, but these froths are not those froth. So these froths are basically the minerals deposit the river springs from the different mountains range and everything. So that is what the froth is, this thing. So you can just put that white color and be very gentle with your painting. Whatever painting, whatever color you are deciding, you can have that thing. Okay, so here you have little bit here, so it can give you so you can have as many as possible. You don't have to worry about what is actually. You can have so much white also, so that you can actually see. Sometimes the reflection is so hard that you can't see into the water. It's actually make your eyes so blind that you can't see it. So it's totally up to you what color, how much white you want to use. There's no restriction. Okay, but I hope you guys are enjoying the painting. The idea is to enjoy the painting, not to worry about. You should forget anything, like, okay, I hope everyone is safe, everyone's neighbor is safe. This COVID situation is making it everyone really, really bad, but making it. So this painting, the idea of this My Kids drawing is to make sure that you guys get an opportunity to, you know, engage yourself. And this is the best medicine, I can say. It can bring a lot of joy in your mindset. And once your mind is happy, you can do anything. So you don't have to worry about anything. I mean, that's the beauty about the painting. You bring the colors, which most people don't see it. But I think you can definitely create a lot of masterpiece of your own. So I'll teach you one more trick. So you can use the cloud from the, how to make the cloud from the brush itself. So I use the cotton, now I'll use a little bit of brush. So what you need to do, you need to use the circular fashion. So use the circular fashion like this and let it from this thing to just clear. Okay, so now I'll just take a little bit this thing. Let's make little bit branches. Okay, let it make it happen. So this branches are little bit white and black getting mixed into it, and the color is getting automatically picking it up, so you don't have to worry about that. So this is detailing. So it looks like we have a morning sunrise with us, and okay, I hope you guys have enjoyed this thing. If you have any questions, please post it, I'll try to respond. So I'll remove this tape now. So one by one. You'll get to know that why we are using the tape. So this is the painting. I hope you guys all enjoy this painting. It looks like we have 10 minutes. We have exceeded 10 minutes extra. But thank you. Have a nice weekend evening. Thank you all. Thank you for joining. Thank you, My Kids Drawing, for giving the opportunity to, pursue this. Thank you all. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.